Assalamu alaikum, Jama. Shall we start?
Nice watch.
Thank you very much. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa sallallahu sallam wa barak ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam wa tasliman kathira thumma amma ba'd. Do you remember what was the chapter's title last night? I know you wasn't here, but somebody else know. So what was the chapter last night, Jama'ah, we were talking about?
Cheating.
So is it permissible or not? So cheating is haram, right? What kind of cheating that is haram? No cheating is allowed. You can't cheat. Is that clear, Jama'ah? So whether it's in business, whether it's in the exam, in your interviews, whatever that you do, you are not allowed to cheat. I hope this is clear to you, inshallah ta'ala. Now, well, that's a different story. We don't bring the word thing right now. Taib, so we discussed cheating last night, and then now Imam An-Nawawi rahimahullah in his book, Riyad al-Salihin, Kitab al-Umur al-Manhiya Anha, the book of the prohibited matters, under the prohibition of cheating, he mentions few ahadith about one particular practice in business. قال وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا تناجشوا. The messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he says, do not practice an najash. Don't practice najash. Another hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم نهى عن النجش متفق عليه. He forbade the practice of a najash. What's the meaning of a najash? A najash has two meanings. Number one, it means cheating in general. And number two, has a specific practice in business. What is that? You know when you go to an auction, and then there's a car being sold over there. Now the car goes up from 1,000, 2,000, then 2,500, then 2,000, you know, 700, and so on. So some two individuals now, they're fighting for it. One of them, he lost interest in the car, but he's not gonna let go without causing that person basically some loss in the business. So he started raising the price just to hurt him. He's not going to buy it. He now just raising the price just to hurt him. That's called najash, is not allowed. Another form of a najash would be the opposite way. Some friends together, they want to sell their friend's car. So what they do, they add more participation into it to help him raise the price. So a guy brings his children, and he has, mashallah, 4 or 5 kids and all are grown up, tabarakallah. So he starts, you know, auctioning on his car. The car goes for 1,000. His kids start now betting on their father's car, so that people can see, oh, mashallah, that's a hot commodity. Then maybe it's some interest in this car. So they start raising the price, so that finally one of those people who are not just out there buys the car at a very high price, when he could have bought it maybe for less price, if they were honest with that. This is also considered also a tanajash, as a najash or a tanajash. This practice is haram because it's cheating. You're not interested in really buying it. You're only interested in causing damage or loss to somebody else. And that's not fair. That's not permissible. Or the word najash itself, it means just cheating in general. And like we said, you know, cheating can be in almost everything. In business, in personal life, in, you know, being in honesty and so on. The final hadith, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam here mentioned something in order to protect yourself from that. Somebody might say, so how am I going to protect myself from this? The Prophet taught us one thing, which is the sense of honesty and decency when it comes to trading and dealing with people. عن ابن عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه قال ذكر رجل لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه يخدع في البيوع فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من بايعت فقل لا خلابة متفق عليه. In this hadith, a man mentioned to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that he was often deceived in dealings. And Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him, when you enter into a transaction, you should say, there should be no deception. Which means when you talk to people and you think that they are now trying to cheat you, Islamically and legally, you have the right to tell them, by the way, I accept with one condition, that there is no hidden strings in there. Which means you're not deceiving me. There is nothing you're hiding in this. In this case, if they say nothing is hidden there, and there would be anything afterwards appears to be hidden, you have all the right to revoke that deal. So you have the right to revoke that deal right away. They cannot say, well, it's sold already. Well, I told you, nothing hidden, and you hid this from me. So the Prophet ﷺ gave us the chance to kind of avoid this sale if there was any deception discovered afterwards. So the sense of asking people to be honest and decent in the marketplace is basically, is just by telling them, no cheating, not as telling them no cheating, but saying that so there is nothing hidden there, nothing that I need to be aware of. When you ask these questions, you tell them, be honest with me. I want you to be honest with me. That's what exactly means when you ask the people to avoid hiding anything from you. So from this chapter, again, one of those bad manners or bad characteristic that as a community you would like to work on for the next few days, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala, is to avoid the sense of deception, the sense of cheating. You might say, alhamdulillah, Sheikh, we don't do that over here. That's great. At least stay conscious about it. Stay conscious and make sure that whatever you say to people, whatever you do with people, there is no deception there. When you go to work and you deal with people, don't try to cheat and don't try to deceive people. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you among those who are decent and honest, jama'ah. Wallahu alam. Any question? MashaAllah, very quiet night tonight. Subhanakallah wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.